so beautiful when covered with snow. Ooh, it's so cold here. My hands are freezing.
Good morning, JC.
Good morning, Uncle. It's so cold here.
Yes, JC. Let's go in the living room. I have lit the fire in the fireplace.
Okay. It is nice and warm down here.
Oh yes. The fire gives out heat and keeps this place warm. I love staying here. And I am glad that you came over for the holidays. You enjoy the warmth of the fire. Meanwhile, I will cook some yummy breakfast.
What are these two tubes? They look like thermometers to me.
Hello, JC. Good morning. I'm Cecilia.
Hi, JC. Good morning. I am Faisal.
Hi.
Let me tell you more about me. I am a Celsius thermometer.
And I am a Fahrenheit thermometer. You can use us to accurately measure the temperature.
Okay.
So, what brings you to this hill station, JC?
I have come here on a vacation. This place looks amazing. Everything is covered with snow and it is much cooler here. It's never so cold where I live. In fact, it doesn't even snow there.
JC, do you know why you feel cooler here compared to your own place?
I can't figure out the reason, Faisal.
Let me explain to you, JC. The heat from the sun reaches straight down to the earth. Therefore, you feel hot. We feel less hot as we go farther away from the earth's surface. That's why the temperature on a hill station is cooler.
But what exactly is temperature?
Temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness of a body or the environment. We can feel temperature or see our body react to temperature when we sweat or shiver. This is where we come in.
You see, JC, thermometers were invented for measuring temperature.
Did you know, JC, that our name thermometer is derived from two Greek words?
Oh, what are those two words, Cecilia?
The two Greek words are thermo, meaning warm, and meter, meaning to measure.
Faisal, how do you both measure temperature?
JC, we are made up of a transparent glass tube and contain liquid such as alcohol or mercury. When the liquid comes into contact with something warm, it rises up.
And when the liquid comes in contact with something cold, it shrinks.
Okay.
As the liquid moves up and down, depending on temperature, you can measure it by looking at the markings present on us.
The markings on my body are numbered from 0 to 100. Each marking represents 1 degree Celsius.
Why the marking is from 0 to 100 only?
Water freezes as the liquid level drops to 0 degree Celsius. This is called the freezing point of water. Water boils as the liquid level rises to 100 degree Celsius. This is called the boiling point of water. Degree is the unit of measure shown on the thermometer. Look closer, JC. Can you see? There are horizontal markings on me. After each 4 horizontal lines, 5th line is marked for the reading.
Oh, this is just like reading a meter scale.
Yes, JC. You know, JC, the Celsius scale is used in the metric system. In India, we follow the metric system. Oh, I forgot to mention my cousin Clinky. She is a clinical thermometer. She is used to measure the temperature of the human body.
Hey, I have met her. Whenever I had fever, Mom used a clinical thermometer to measure my body temperature. Faisal, tell me something more about yourself.
Well, I have markings starting from 32 to 212, which you read as degree Fahrenheit.
water freezes as the liquid inside me drops to 32 degree Fahrenheit. This is called the freezing point of water. Water boils as the liquid level rises to 212 degree Fahrenheit. This is called the boiling point of water.
As Celsius scale is used in metric system, Fahrenheit scale is used in the United States of America.
Oh, Faisal, that means you both show different readings for the same temperature.
Yes, JC. When you read 0 degree Celsius on Cecilia, it is equal to 32 degree Fahrenheit on me.
Okay.
You must have noticed that there is a relation between me and Cecilia.
Yes, Faisal. You both are measured in degrees.
Absolutely right. Therefore, degree Fahrenheit can always be converted into degree Celsius. The method is to first subtract 32 from the given value, then multiply it by 5 upon 9 to get the temperature in degree Celsius.
Okay, JC, you can even convert temperature given in degree Celsius to degree Fahrenheit.
Oh, how can we do that?
The method is very simple. First, multiply the given value by 9 upon 5 and then add it to 32 to get the temperature in degree Fahrenheit.
Oh, I got it now. Can you both show me one example?
Sure. JC, imagine the temperature is 122 degree Fahrenheit. To convert in degree Celsius, do the following steps.
Step 1. Subtract 32 from 122. This gives us 90.
Step 2. Multiply 90 by 5 upon 9. This gives us 50.
Thus, the answer is 50 degrees Celsius.
It is very simple to convert.
Yes, JC. If it is 98.6 Fahrenheit, then what is the temperature in degrees Celsius?
First, I will subtract 32 from 98.6 to get 66.6. Then I will multiply 66.6 by 5 upon 9 to get 37 degrees Celsius.
Very good, JC. JC, can you find out what the temperature will be in Fahrenheit when it is 23 degrees Celsius?
Yes, of course. First multiply 23 by 9 upon 5. This gives us 41.4. Now add 32 to 41.4. This gives us 73.4 degrees Fahrenheit.
Very good, JC. Well done.
JC, breakfast is ready.
Coming. Hey, I've got to go now. But I've definitely learnt a lot about temperature. Bye.
Bye, JC.
Bye, JC.
Let's revise all that we have learned about temperature and thermometer. Temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness of a body or the environment. Temperature is measured using a thermometer. The Celsius thermometer has readings from 0 to 100 degrees Celsius. Fahrenheit thermometer has readings from 32 to 212 degrees Fahrenheit. A clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of the human body. To convert degree Fahrenheit into degree Celsius, first subtract 32 from the temperature in Fahrenheit, then multiply by 5 upon 9 to get the reading in degree Celsius. To convert degree Celsius into degree Fahrenheit, first multiply temperature in degree Celsius by 9 upon 5, then add 32 to get the reading in degree Fahrenheit.